Praxis Prepper.
Hey everybody, this is Praxis. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that I've been running a series over the past couple years called Project Homestead Little House of Quarantine. It's a fairly boring series about the nuts and bolts of day-by-day accounting of building a homestead and everything related to it. And because of that, there's fairly low viewership on it, but occasionally there is a topic that comes up that I think it might have broader appeal to people, and that's what today's video is about. And it's about starting your own orchard from bare root trees. Bare root trees are a way of saving maybe about 50% off the cost of buying trees already in a planter from a garden center. So I tried it out with a lot of trees that I'm going to be putting at the next homestead. I want to share my experiences with you. Now, I bought these trees from two different suppliers. One of them I had a 100% success rate with, one I had a 50% success rate with. So I'm going to share with you exactly which of those suppliers were and which one I had good luck with and which one I didn't at the end of this video. But at first I want to tell you a little bit about the process of what it's like to get bare root trees. Now, when they show up, they're in a long box and you open it up and it essentially looks like a dead stick. There's no leaves or anything like that on it. Just got some chopped branches and some roots at the bottom, sometimes not even really that many roots. Whatever is there for roots is going to be wrapped in like wet newspaper shreds or wet sawdust or wood chips or something like that, and the whole thing's going to be bundled up in plastic. As soon as you get it, you want to make sure everything is wet, maybe soak it for a little bit, half hour or something like that, and then get it right into some good dirt. Ideally, you could put a bunch of compost in your ground and put them right into the ground and then be watering them, fairly frequently every day. You want to make sure that they get a good dousing of water so the roots can start growing. That's the ideal situation. I couldn't do that here because I'm only temporarily at this house. The homestead that I'm building, I don't have reliable access to water there, so I can take care of the plants here and I'm gonna have to move them there later. I ended up putting a lot of these bare root trees in these old planters that I had from other things that I've gotten from garden centers, but I ended up running out of those pots, and I was also able to use the paper bags that come from like 25 pounds of flour or cornmeal or oats or whatever. I was able to use some of those paper bags as planters. I kind of cut off the top, curled the tops down so they had some rigidity, and those seem like they're working out pretty well as planters. I think that there's some plastic layers in the middle of those too that makes it so that the paper doesn't so quickly transmit the water out, but overall they seem like they're working out pretty well. Now, I mentioned that I've gone with two different orchards. One was Gurney's, Gurney's Nursery. You can go online, you can get all sorts of different selection. It's really a fun website to go around because they just have so many different options for you. I got stuff from Gurney's and I had a 100% success rate with everything that Gurney sent me. It arrived here pretty quickly and everything, went into, budding out leaves, within a week or so. Gurney's, really good success rate with them. This and this tree came from another orchard, which was Online Orchards, actually, is the name of them. And half the stuff that came from Online Orchards, I think, arrived dead. It took almost a month for the stuff to show up. I don't know if it was Online Orchards' fault or that the company that was doing the deliveries were in the middle of the coronavirus pandemic, so there were delivery delays and things. Maybe the stuff was just sitting on the back of a truck for a couple of weeks, slowly dying. But whatever the circumstances, half the stuff from Online Orchards, I think arrived dead. These have been here like a month and there's just no sign of life. Now, there is a return policy on them. I can bring them back. In fact, I bought them through Home Depot and Home Depot subbed it out to Online Orchards, so I can bring them back to Home Depot and they'll accept them and everything. But it's a pain in the butt. If you buy something, you kind of want the stuff to arrive alive. So I'm just throwing that out there. That doesn't mean that your experience is going to be the same. That's just my own personal experience in buying, several dozen trees that half the stuff from Online Orchards died or was dead when it arrived, and 100% of the Gurney stuff is still alive. That's the basic process. And like I said, you save an enormous amount of money because it's like half the cost of buying the stuff already in the pots. And the variety and selection is also really good because, you're getting the stuff from their huge center and it can get sent out. If you're just going to your local garden center, they may not have all the different varieties that you might be interested in. So bare root trees, I think, is a cool option because it saves you a lot of money, gives you more flexibility. And so far, it seems like it's working out pretty well, especially the Gurney stuff, 100% success rate. And I can't wait to get the stuff in the ground because an orchard is just such a great way of getting food out of your garden. Normally your garden, it's like you have to plant the seedlings anew every single year, unless it's like raspberries or blueberries or whatever, which you can get through Gurney's. But usually a lot of garden crops you have to start them fresh every year. Once you get an orchard going, once it's established, it's really just as long as the plants were chosen appropriately for the region that you're in, you essentially just have free food that's pumping out of your earth all the time. And it's a good feeling, and I'm really looking forward to probably, 4 years from now when these things start giving me some fruit. That's it. Thanks for watching.
This episode is brought to you in part by Burning Hearth Homestead, a nonprofit that aims to provide seeds, live plants, and education to the community, both local and extended. Plant seeds, plant knowledge, plant the future. If you'd like to thank them for supporting this channel or find out more about what they do, go to burninghearthhomestead.org. Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.